that flashed in my room was both lamps. My monitor stayed on, my computer stayed on.
Yeah, so did my stuff. But the router dropped.
Just because of that less than a half a second of it being down.
That's all it takes sometimes. Yeah, it's back up. 3,000 gigs of internet, apparently, that we've used. Oh my god, that's a lot of space.
What's Buster yelling about?
He won't tell me.
We're talking full-on conversations with your four-legged friends.
How can we help, my dude?
And your pets are your favorites for the same reason as Gold Peak. They're always real with you.
Oh, he says your shorts are too short for a dad your age.
Ouch.
His words, not mine.
So you stay all ears, we'll stay real brood, and the world will be golder because of it. Gold Peak Real Brood Tea. Stay gold.
Got a little drunk last night.
Small power blank. Sorry about that, guys.
Everybody here ain't from here, but we're here doing
our thing. I do apologize for that.
Letting go a little, little by little, sipping on a frozen drink. Take it, Marsh, take it, pour it all week, and clouds ain't leaking no rain. Two pieces shaking, white caps breaking, we ain't feeling no pain. It goes like one margarita, two margarita, three margarita shot. Don't worry about tomorrow, leave all your sorrow out here on the floating dock. When that sun lays down, we'll be on our way. One more barefoot round, one more last chance to say, hey señorita, don't you think we need a Salt and a Buffett song? One margarita, two margarita, three margarita, we'll be.
But I want to say that once it happened, and I knew it happened because I literally, my main monitor, where I game from, actually broke, you know, flashed. Basically went on and off real quick. And when it did that, I knew that my stream was going to drop. So I immediately paused the game, immediately. And waited for, you know, my stream to come back up and my internet to come back in. So I do apologize for that, but, you know, again, out of my control, completely 100% out of my control. Now, I wanted to say, NASCAR raced at Circuit of Americas. God, that race was boring.
Fantastic. It's a brilliant result. Well done.
What? Far too many laps. And two, they didn't even finish the fucking race.
Like it's time for the victory ceremony once again, as I can see the drivers beginning to make their So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Nikita Mazepin takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship after that excellent result. And now, Davide Valsecchi, let me ask you, who is your driver of the day?
Carlo Magnussen. For me, he made the difference. He was just the best driver of the day. Overall.
And now a look at the team standings. ART moved to the top of the table. There was also a strong showing from the Uni Virtuosi team today as they make their way up the standings. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then.
So that was an exciting race from our perspective. Let's have yours. How do you feel you performed today? You're still in the running for the championship. What do you think of your chances going forward? There are still rumors about you moving to F1 at the end of the season. Can you comment on those?
When I'm ready to announce something, I'll let you know.
Appreciate your time.
We're back. For the second race, we've reversed the top eight from yesterday, and everyone here is getting ready for what's shaping up to be a thrilling conclusion to the weekend. Yas Marina Circuit is a 3.4-mile racetrack built on the man-made Yas Island. In addition to the 21 corners, it features two very long straights. Now, these will be the driver's main overtaking chances today, into Turn 8 and Turn 11. I'm not the only one sitting here today who's looking forward to today's race. My friend and ex-GP2 champion, Davide Valsecchi, next to me, is already on the edge of his seat awaiting the start of the event. How's it going today?
Hello there, Alex. I'm great, thank you. And very excited to get started. I have a feeling we are in for a very special event today.
That means I finished second at the race. So, in the feature race. Finishing the top three to secure the championship. Got it! God damn it, dude. Seriously, like, why are they braking so much in these corners?
What we like to see at the start. Well done. Been awarded a ton. Nice work. That brings you up a place.
Six places in two apps. All the way up to first from seventh in two apps. That's a little bit unrealistic, but I'll take it. And since I'm in my zone right now, I'm gonna do this just so I can focus on bringing this car home.
Gone. Ice blue sky, shades on the ice that took the bloodshot away. Hair of the dog shouldn't take long, but who cares what got all day?
I just won't let it happen, you know? I enjoy what I do.
We're increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap.
While I am quiet most of the time on stream, I do care quite a bit. But my mind works in a very devious way that doesn't allow me to really speak as freely as I would like, because I've just built so many barriers over the years to protect me and who I am, that getting through those barriers even for me is a challenge, because I've built them so tightly wound up. And it's one of the reasons why I say a lot of times that I'm actually emotionally disconnected from the world, because I don't feel emotion. You know, I was talking to my therapist yesterday about a subject that should be, you know, a subject that should be specifically really, really hard on me, and I was talking about it with so much ease, but it was hurting. It was taking a lot out of me to talk about it, because it's such a touchy thing with me. Like, it's, you know, I have to trust my therapist a lot to be able to speak about it, because it's so touchy. You say the wrong thing to me and I go off on you, and that's the exact opposite of what I want to do to him. But, you know, he lets me speak and lets me do what I need to do to get through it, as his job is.
Fantastic. You've won the Grand Prix.
A great win then for the Prema team today. As we look back on a thrilling race here today, we can now see the drivers take their places on the podium. It's a familiar sight by now, as it's another successful F2 win for Prema. Now then, Davide Valsecchi, who would you say was your driver of the day?
It's a difficult call, but I'm going to give it to the Prema driver.
Hey, by 6 points we took it. Holy shit!
That's a good skill.
Wow, that is close.
Have taken the team's championship title. They are this year's Formula 2 team champions.
Wow, that was...
After all that excitement, I think it's time for a lie down. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you when Formula 2 returns.
There we go, 6 point differential.
Amazing performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. 2019 Formula 2 champion. How does it feel to take the championship? Has this season been easy for you, or has it been a struggle to? What are your plans for your future career? Are you able to talk about them yet?
With Red Bull, no less. Yes, I am picking Red Bull. As long as I get a free choice on that, of course. Teammate, Verstappen, 22 race schedule, 100%, 75 because Mercedes is the top team, so I just don't want to deal with
recommend we could go for something like this. New parts have been completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend. What do you think of this one? If it were me, this is probably what I'd invest in.
Well, I just realized how much lower the performance board is. Interesting.
You're done with the technician's briefing. Look, I know we've got a lot to get through in FP1, but Will Buxton's been pushing for a quick interview before you head out on track. Don't worry too much. He's a good lad. He's just over there. These media appearances are important for a few reasons. They'll help build your profile and your brand. Plus, your team will get a real boost to their motivation if they hear you praising them. Will, as promised, sorry to keep you waiting.
So that's how you get him.
We've got to be out on track in about 5 minutes for FP1, so we can only spare you a couple of minutes max. Is that going to be enough time?
More than enough. We're already set up. Cool, let's go. We We're used to seeing rookies in Formula One every year.
That's how you get the other press interview. Okay.
Interest in them than usual. And that's because while they've been successful at every level of their career from karts all the way through to Formula Two, they've somehow managed to stay pretty much under the radar. They don't have that.
I like that.
Anymore, they're in Formula One. Millions of people around the world watching their every move, both on and off the racetrack. So let's take some time to get to know them a little bit better. So tell us a little about yourself. What's the thing you're most excited about being here in Formula One?
Definitely the competition. Other drivers are really going to push my limits. Yes, they are.
Junior career, you must have had a lot of interest. What drew you to sign for your current team? What do you think your prospects are for the season? Are you aiming just for points, or do you think you've got a chance at the title?
I'm actually going to go with an honest answer here. And I'm just going to say I'm aiming for points.
Really appreciate your time, but I know you're very keen to get on. Best of luck out there.
And the reason why I say that is because this is supposed to be my fun career. The career where I, you know, kind of back off, per se. You know, where I don't...
This first race of the season is always quite difficult for us trackside, and for those back at the factory as well, as it's the first time the car has run since winter testing. The more consistent mileage you can get in these sessions, the happier we'll be.
Now, I am going to use my setup. Of course, that was made for the Mercedes car, but...
Okay, your goal is to get through as many corner gates as quickly and precisely as possible. Remember to activate your DRS in the DRS zone as well. DRS zone is coming up. Get ready to open it. Distance is on your MFD. Great stuff. You've pretty much nailed this circuit. This is a really strong foundation to build from over the weekend.
I will say, though, the Honda Indian definitely sounds way different.
fantastic. You obviously have a really good understanding of this circuit.
Now, I wonder how the game's gonna do the narrative. So, for the next game. Because, I've been playing NBA 2K21, and that game's made it very clear about, you know, the 2020 season, and how much of a jumbled mess that season ended up becoming because of, you know, the pandemic and everything else. But I just wonder what the game's gonna do. You know, is it gonna act like nothing happened? Is the game gonna have an option randomly for having crowds or not having crowds? You know, things like that.
That's the end of the program. Box this lap so we can analyze the data. Box this lap.
Or is the game just not gonna even mention anything about that at all?
Come in this lap, please. Box this lap.
You know, and that's the biggest thing, like, the new game, when it comes out, that's why I'm so excited for it, because not only will we get the 23 race schedule that we were supposed to get, and I'm telling you this because I know what the game did. Trust me. I know Codemasters. EA isn't going to just all of a sudden step in and say, no, you need to do the official F1 schedule. No. Let's not go there, because that's a hell of a recode job. You don't understand, like, if in order for this game to have even done it, they would have had to recode the entire career mode. Like, it's not a thing that they can do. Can they put the tracks in and add a separate schedule for that? Yes. And that's the simple fix. The problem is all the extra coding, all the extra tracks, you know, because people are already requesting that we get Turkey, we get, you know, this track, we get that track, we get Nürburgring, we get that track. The problem is the more tracks you put in, the more assets, the bigger the game size, everything becomes a much bigger percentage.
Of fuel, almost out of fuel. You need to pit within the next 2 laps. Less than a lap of fuel now. The tank is empty.
Okay. We'll have to do a difficulty adjustment. Holy shit, that's a massive difference.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1 minute 23.8. Give us some consistent laps, please. We're looking for good data that we can work into the race strategy. Lab, you've nailed what we asked for. Keep it up.
I do kind of like the Honda engine sound, though. It's a little bit more, you know, smooth. You know what I mean? You know, and I've been thinking about this, you know, I've ran, you know, 10 years with Mercedes now. I think for the next game.
Okay, super job so far. We're getting great data. Stay focused.
I'm debating. Still sticking with the Mercedes engine. But I'm debating McLaren or Aston Martin. That's what I'm debating. Do I go... And... Now, I could do it this way. I could do a year with McLaren. I could then go and do a year with Aston Martin. And then I could do my third year with my Mercedes team. Here's the biggest thing with this game, and this is why I love the career mode now, is every year I could switch teams. Regardless. Every single year I could switch teams. And I would only do it every year because of the engine wear. Keep it up. So we'll probably race at 80, maybe 85. Nah, we'll do 80. We'll do expert for the first year. I think that'll be pretty competitive for us. Qualifying at 60, race at 80. Just so that way, you know, we have a... Just so I can ensure pole, but at the same time, so... You know, have a challenge in the race. And, again, as I said, this is supposed to be my more fun career. Meaning that I'm not gonna, you know, battle as hard to win. I'm gonna try to fight my urge that, you know, I have to win every race that I'm in. I'm gonna try to fight that. However, because of how strong that urge is with me, it may not be something that is a foreseeable thing.
Okay, test.
Ooh, I was actually below the expected tire wear. Ouch.
Lab, you've nailed what we asked for. Keep it up.
I mean, we have 10 teams, right? So, I mean, believe it or not, I could race every season of a career mode with a different team. Even a backmarking team. If that meant, you know, taking and cutting the difficulty down to, you know, easy so I could win, I may do that. So, like, with a team like Haas, give Haas a championship. Get, you know, teams like that. Williams, you know.
Okay, super job so far.
I'm one of those people that I believe that, you know, the game is my oyster to be able to do stuff that, you know, you may not see in real life. So, taking McLaren and picking McLaren and taking them and getting them a championship for the first time since Lewis Hamilton, that is something that I'm actually envisioning. And because McLaren is back to Mercedes power, I'm envisioning it even stronger. You have to understand, McLaren and Mercedes have a real-life partnership, too. If you've ever looked up the McLaren or the Mercedes-Benz 722S, that was actually a project between McLaren and Mercedes. The Stirling Moss car was another one. McLaren has also worked with Mercedes on several of their cars. So, again, McLaren and Mercedes are really good partners in real life, which is why I'm not surprised by Norris's finish at Monaco. That's why I'm not surprised by how McLaren has done this year. Because the partnership between them and Mercedes is so strong that, believe it or not, now granted, McLaren is not a sister team to Mercedes-Benz in terms of F1 teams. The sister team to Mercedes is Williams. Everybody says, oh, but how could that be possible? How could they have such a sister team that's so shitty? Have you seen how Russell's been doing this year? Like, Russell has taken his car and put it in Q2 every single race. Like, Russell is driving the wheels off of his Williams. Now, granted, it'd be better if his teammate was doing better. It sure as hell would be better if, you know, his teammate was winning. But right now, in this practice session, I want to point something out. Who's first, who's second? Or who's second and who's third, and where's my teammate? If that is our exact running order for the race,
okay,
we take the championship.
So far, we're getting great data. Stay focused.
If me and Verstappen could do that consistently, I will do something that I've never done in the game. Ever.
Car repairs have set us back a little. So far, our fastest lap is a 1:23.8.
Now, I will turn that back on.
This test is all about tire management. Try to control the slip through each corner and take extra care putting the power down at the apex.
at how much I'm feathering the throttle, though, out of these corners just to get this.
Okay, test.
Return to garage. Like, I had to let off quite a bit through there. Just to get that in the purple section. Now again, because this is a new career mode, that's why I'm doing all this stuff.
In this program, we're looking at ERS management. This is all about managing your battery efficiently throughout the lap to hit your target time. The overtake button will drain the battery quickly, but it will also give you maximum power.
Perfect.
Top of the speed trap, 200.1 miles per hour.
I
think that's the program.
I know I'm faster on the program, and I should have pull locked. The only reason why I was slower there was because the Haas got in the way.
Lap so far is a 1 minute 23.8.
And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again.
Like I said, qualify at 60 for pole, race at 80 for the race. I'm going to restore the wing angles, though, which was, 4 and 7, I think it was. Wow, we are lowest on this board. Holy shit. Second lowest on the reliability side. Oh boy. That's not good. It's a 13 lap difference. Well, let's see. Wow. So, according to that, though, 610 laps, that's not a very long time on the engine. And because of that, I'm actually going to take... basically, the turbo, the kinetic, and the ICE, swap them, and actually the energy store as well. Those four components, I'm going to swap and swap consistently for the race for the time being. So,
I
Fantastic. You've got pole.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Schumacher, Verstappen, and Lewis Hamilton. Goodbye for now.
Now that is an interesting front row. Shit. Because I'm not going to be able to turn that back on, I don't think.
Well done. Very solid result. You're looking good for the race.
Fuck. And I really need that on. Let me just see something. If I quit out and load back in, if it'll allow me to change that. Because I need the formation lap. Yep, there we go. Okay. Don't want to do 80 just because I want to feel it out first. And it's also worth noting we're only doing the one race.
Well done. That was a good qualifying performance.
Before we begin,
pole position. Let's go for the win. Okay, our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tires and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap.
Look at me and Verstappen, though.